Because of how versatile they are, the popularity of 2-in-1 convertible laptops is on the rise. From portable design to multiple use cases, these devices offer so much more than a traditional laptop. And today, I have the new ASUS ZenBook Flip 13 UX363 in for review. Featuring a compact body and a vibrant OLED display, this 2-in-1 convertible is a pretty interesting device. You can find two configurations of this laptop, one with Intel's Tiger Lake Core i5 processor and the other with the i7 CPU. Our review unit is the high-end i7 variant that is coupled with 16GB of RAM and 512GB of SSD storage. While this configuration retails for some $1,200 in the US, here in Nepal it costs around 1,75,000 rupees. As usual, allow me to kick things off with the design. The ZenBook lineup from ASUS has always offered premium design while also retaining lightweight build quality, and the ZenBook Flip 13 is no different. It looks very similar to the ZenBook 14 that I reviewed a while back, except for the 360-degree hinge, which, by the way, feels plenty sturdy. ASUS says that you're good for at least 20,000 cycles of opening and closing this hinge. To maintain rigidity under different modes, ASUS has been clever enough to engineer a sort of obstacle in between so that the hinge does not slide away at every go. This implementation is pretty common in 2-in-1 laptops, which ultimately lets you enjoy the device in multiple form factors. Besides the regular laptop configuration, you can transform it into a tent, a stand, or a tablet mode. These are productivity-focused orientations and are geared towards content sharing intention. ASUS has also included four rubber nubbins on all four edges of the keyboard chassis that absorb the pressure every time you close the lid to prevent any damage. ZenBook Flip 13's air intake vents are situated at the bottom, while the exhaust vents reside on the hinge. Just like the HP Envy X360 that we reviewed a while back, only one half of the vents actually blows out hot air. Moving on, at just 1.3 kgs, my back is incredibly thankful for this lightweight build as well. The protective sleeve that comes inside the box is also one of the most premium looking out there. Moreover, this laptop features minimal bezels on the sides, although the same cannot be said for the top and bottom. If only the company had decided to trim the chin, we could have easily gotten the 16:10 display like with Dell's XPS 13 lineup. This laptop also embeds the Argo Lift hinge design that lifts the bottom chassis to a certain degree to facilitate a more comfortable typing experience while also aiding in effective airflow. Okay, getting to input and output connectivity, you will find two USB Type-C and a full-size HDMI port on the left rear. Here, either USB-C connection accepts power input, is also Thunderbolt 4, DisplayPort, and power delivery compliant. Similarly, the other side is home to a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A port and a minimalistic power button. Like the ZenBook from the past, you don't get a headphone jack here too, but ASUS does provide a USB-C to 3.5mm jack dongle inside the box. Anyways, talking about the display, well, this one is an absolute winner in this front. Featuring a 13.3 inches Full HD OLED panel, there's hardly any alternative that matches the sheer quality of this screen, at least in this part of the world. OLED displays are renowned for their near-perfect contrast levels, and you can probably already tell that I had a great time looking at this beautiful machine. Covering 100% of DCI-P3 color space, ZenBook Flip's display is pleasantly vibrant to look at too. It is Pantone validated as well, meaning that this display has passed all the standards of Pantone matching system. Without getting into any elaborate detail, it is a standardization that helps identify and match colors. What this ultimately means is that the ZenBook Flip is a viable machine for photo or video editors as well. Besides this, the ZenBook Flip has great viewing angles and it can get bright enough to be easily visible outdoors. Anyway, this display is pretty reflective, so you'd most likely want to work in a room with little light sources. ASUS has also managed to obtain TUV Rainlan certification against low blue light emission on this laptop. The company calls it iCare and you can access it from the My ASUS app. You can choose from 5 different levels of blue light reduction to best suit your need. Likewise, the touchscreen experience has been excellent too. It supports multi-touch input and I have no complaints regarding the touch response either. ASUS has also generously thrown in a stylus for free inside the box. It takes a quadruple A battery and has 4096 pressure levels. You can make sketches or take notes with it, although a glossy surface would not be an artist's ideal canvas. Regardless, the inclusion of a free stylus is a welcome move. When it comes to the keyboard and the trackpad, it's pretty much similar to last year's ZenBook 14. The trackpad is not the best, as it would time and again misread my two-finger input as three-finger gesture instead. On certain occasions, I would accidentally trigger number pad too. The keyboard, on the other hand, is wonderful to type on. The keys are adequately spaced out and are incredibly responsive. Likewise, the keys don't rattle much either, and I find its 1.4mm travel distance to be comfortable as well. It is also backlit with three levels of illumination to choose from. However, when you're using the ZenBook Flip on a table with the laptop matching your eye level, the backlight bleed from the top row keys is a little distracting. Okay, now let's get into the performance section of this review, and like I mentioned earlier, our unit of the ZenBook Flip 13 comes with Intel's Tiger Lake Core i7-1165G7 CPU. Unfortunately, there is no discrete GPU on this machine, not even the entry-level MX series from Nvidia. Still and all, Intel has made great strides on this generation of integrated graphics, as the Iris Xe is almost 50% faster than last-gen Intel UHD graphics. While it will struggle if you take it through intensive video editing and 3D rendering projects, Iris Xe is more than capable of handling lightweight projects and even some esports gaming. Talking of gaming, I tried playing a couple of titles on the ZenBook Flip to see how well it performs. CSGO gave a stable 70 to 74 FPS under medium video settings with MSAA2X. Similarly, Valorant was equally playable on this machine, as I was able to get around 54 to 60 FPS at medium quality with MSAA2X. However, because of its compact chassis and non-gaming heritage, there isn't an effective cooling mechanism. Consequently, this laptop would heat up after mere minutes of gaming. By the way, I tested its gameplay under the performance mode, which cranks up the fan speed to the maximum to keep up with the CPU loads. Even with this, the CPU temperature quickly rose to 63 degrees, while the upper left area of the keyboard chassis would feel warm to touch. Still, after around half an hour or so of continuous gaming, the temperature settled to around 68 degrees. And since the loud fan noise under performance mode is not ideal for workspace setting, you can opt for the standard or whisper fan mode instead. On a similar note, multitasking is quite efficient on the ZenBook Flip 13. With 16GB of onboard RAM clocked at 4266MHz, I could simultaneously open multiple tabs on Chrome while also working on word processing application and Adobe Photoshop. Okay, in terms of storage, Asus ships this laptop with 512GB of M.2 PCIe NVMe SSD. The speed is not exceptional, but not that bad either. Okay, similarly, a good webcam is almost a rarity in laptops these days, and this one's no exception either. The 720p camera is fine for general video recording purposes, but don't expect to be blown away by its quality. This IR-infused camera also supports Windows Hello Login. It works perfectly fine in a well-lit environment, but will struggle under dark ambience. Likewise, you get a dual speaker system here certified by Harman-Kardon. The audio sounds pretty well balanced, can get loud enough, and is a decent partner for content consumption. You always Moving on to the battery side of things, the ZenBook Flip 13 is fueled by a 67-watt-hour 4-cell lithium polymer battery. Asus claims that you can get up to 14 hours of screen on time with this setup, but I was able to get around 9 hours of battery life. But still, that's really impressive. Charging up the battery can take somewhere from 1 hour 40 minutes to 2 hours with its 65-watt charger. As I mentioned earlier, you can connect the charging cable to either USB-C ports on the left. Since it also supports USB power delivery, you can also use a 65-watt power delivery compliant smartphone charger for an even sleeker computing experience. To conclude, the Asus ZenBook Flip 13 is a great 2-in-1 laptop. From its build quality, display, battery life, to even performance, it is pretty impressive. And with the versatility of use cases that it brings, this laptop also caters to the needs of different demographics. The free stylus that comes inside the box is a sweet gesture as well. If I really, really had to nitpick, it's the lack of a 3.5mm headphone jack and the unoptimized trackpad. But other than that, it is an all-round excellent Ultrabook that I can personally recommend. So that was all for our review of the ASUS ZenBook Flip 13. We also have other interesting product reviews in line. So do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell icon to never miss out on our awesome videos.